Our dear viewers and listeners,
abagalamu enaba tulaba naba tuliriza.
We greet you all in the wonderful and precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Tubalamusako mulinye lyomuwende lyobulokozi gelya Yesu Kristo.
Once again, today is the day the Lord has made.
Natero no lunaku lumukama wafe lwatuwadde.
And we shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Tugenda lusanyukiramu ate tulweyagaliremu.
Today's Bible study.
Okusoma okwa Bible okwa leero.
We continue this wonderful journey.
Tweyongereyo mu lugendo n'olulungi.
In the book of Revelation.
Ngali mu kitabo ky'okubikkulibwa.
And as we open up today's session.
Nga tutandika olwaleero.
Let's dedicate this moment to God in prayer.
Katuweyo akaseera kaleero Mukama mu kusaba.
Let's pray.
Katusabe.
Father, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for the spirit of wisdom and of revelation.
Yes, Lord.
We yield to you, King of glory.
Yes, Lord.
Guide us, O great Redeemer, Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
That in your word we might see light.
Yes, Lord.
That we understand your mind pertaining the end times that you have placed us in.
Yes, Lord.
That many will come to the saving knowledge of the Lord. And many will rise to take this gospel to all the ends of the world.
Yes, Lord.
May you be glorified and exalted in today's teaching.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Mukama feyebazibwe.
Today's text.
Ebyawandikibwa byolwaleero.
Will be from the book of Revelation.
Biva mu kitabo ekyokubikkulibwa.
Chapter 19.
Esula ya 19.
From verse 11.
Tutaandikire mu lunyiriri lwa 11
to verse 16.
Mpaka mu 16.
This is what John writes.
Yokana awandika.
Now I saw heaven open.
Nenda beggulu nga libikuddwa.
And behold, a white horse.
Nenda bembalasi enjeru.
And he who sat on him was called faithful and true.
Eyali ajituddeko nga ayitibwa ow'amazima era omwesigwa.
And in righteousness he judges and makes war.
Nga ne mu butuukirivu mw'asalira emisango n'okulwana.
His eyes were like the flame of fire.
Nga amaaso ge galingo omuliro ogwaka.
And on his head were many crowns.
Nga ku mutwe kuliko engule nnyingi.
He had a name written that no one knew except himself.
Nga alina erinnya eriwandikiddwa ng'omuntu yenna ly'atamanyi wabula ye yekka.
He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood.
Ng'ayambadde ekyambalo ekyanyikibwa mu musaayi.
And his name is called the Word of God.
Ng'erinnya lye ly'ekigambo kya Katonda.
And the armies in heaven.
N'amagye g'omuggulu.
Clothed in fine linen, white and clean.
Ng'agambadde bafuta enjere nnungi.
Followed him on white horses.
Nga bamugoberera ku mbalaasi enjeru.
Now, out of his mouth goes a sharp sword.
Nga mukamwa kwe muva ekitala ekyobwoje.
That with it he should strike the nations.
Kyatemesa amawanga.
And he himself will rule them with a rod of iron.
Era alibafuga n'omuggo ogw'ekyuma.
He himself treads the winepress of the fierceness and the wrath of Almighty God.
Ye mwene yalinnya essoggolero ly'omwenge gw'obusungu bw'obukambwe bwa Katonda omuyinza w'ebintu byonna.
And he has on his robe and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Alina ku kyambalo kye ne ku kisambi kye erinnya eriwandiikiddwa nti Kabaka w'abakabaka era Mukama w'abakama.
What a marvelous description.
Okunyonyolwa kuno nga si kwa bulijjo.
Of Christ.
Okujjayo Kristo.
When he comes again in glory.
W'aliba akomawo mu kitiibwa.
In the text, John is back in heaven.
Mu byawandiikibwa Yokaana azzeeyo mu ggulu.
We've seen the destruction of the harlot on earth.
Batulaze okuzikiriza omwenzi ku nsi.
But then next test we shall see the destruction of the beast.
Kati ebyandiko ebinaddako tujja kulaba okuzikirira kw'ensolo.
Today we are looking at Jesus.
Leero amaaso gali ku Yesu.
In majesty and glory.
Mu bitiibwa.
Now at a time like this when we are in the season of Christmas.
Mu kaseera nga kano nga tuyingidde mu gandaalo.
As we go to the time of celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ.
Nga tujjukira n'okusanyukira wamu amazaalibwa gwa Yesu Kristo.
Which literally December is all about.
Nga omwezi gwa December gwe mutwe omukulu.
I often sit down to look at people moving up and down.
Tula nnyo ne neetegereza abantu nga bava eno n'eri.
The roads are filled with heavy traffic going to the countryside.
ngengudo zijude traffic abantu bagenda mu byalo.
As people go to have Christmas, celebrate Christmas with their loved ones.
Ngabagenda okulya sekukulu wamu n'abaagalwa.
The flurry of activity is unmistakable.
Emikolo mingi n'ebintu bye bakola.
The shopping centers are crowded.
Ngamaduuka gajjudde abantu.
Homes and offices are decorated.
Amaka n'ebifo ebibakolerwamu nga bijjudde ebintu.
Streets and buildings are filled with lighting.
Ngengudo n'amayumba bagataddeko ebitangaala.
Songs are of a particular genre.
Nga n'ennyimba za kigendererwa.
So there is a mood that takes over the entire countryside.
Katembere
and city.
Echuka netwale bibuga n'ebyalo wamu.
That is surely a time of merrymaking.
Kaseera ka masanyu na ganda.
It is a time of festival.
Kaseera ka mikolo na kusanyuka.
From the worship places.
Okuva mu bifo by'amasinzizo.
To the places of work.
Nebi fobe tukoleramu.
In certain institutions have become so generous during that season.
Nebi tongole mbitandika okubaako nga bigaba ebintu ebimu ebyabo.
So they don't just give out cards, they give out presents, they give out gift hampers to their staff.
Tebako makuwa kadi okaneba bawa nebirabo.
Often when you go to buy something, they give you either a calendar or something to just say thank you, just to celebrate the mood of the season.
Nga wabu ogenza wanto gule miti mu abamba kuwa ne kadi o kujaga nyawamu na urembele ne ye ganda.
But what I find is the contrast when we come to celebrating the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Ne kati wenchigira gea neche okusanyu kila munga tusanyu kora mazu kila gamu kama wafi Yesu Kristo.
Because we don't see so much of that celebration. And I often ask myself, why is that so? One time I was discussing this with a friend. And he said, I think this is in part to the reason that when we think about Christmas, what comes to our minds is a helpless baby. And you see, when you look at a helpless baby, that puts you in charge to give and to take care. Now, on the other hand, when you look at the rising of Jesus from the dead, this has implications because he is Lord of heaven and earth. He's the Lord of life and death. He is all conquering. He comes forward as a victor. So if he comes as a victor, where does that place you and I? So we either join him and proclaim him as Lord, or we become the vanquished. Because that is what will happen to all his enemies. See, the reason Jesus is Lord, and that is the picture we have today. The picture that he is coming again to this world. And from the text that we saw, a number of things stand out. One, his coming will be visible. You shall be able to see it with your naked eye. Every eye shall see him. So that it will not be something that will need to be told to you. If we are alive at the moment when he shows up, every eye will see him. Secondly, it will be literal. It will not be a vision. It will not be an apparition. It will not be a hologram. It will not be something made up. It will be literal.
tekijja kuba kiyiiye ujja mulaba nga mu buli wo.
So it not be like you are watching TV and you are watching me on this side. No, you will physically be able to see it.
Ojja kiraba mu buli wo, tojja kubeera nga adaba TV wano.
So it will be a physical manifestation.
Yesu ajja kulabika mu buli wo.
And finally, it will be glorious.
Era jira mu kitiibwa.
So he's not going to come with a whimper. The first time he came,
we are so called Kujamunsi.
He came as a baby.
Yajanga muwere.
The next time he shows up, he's coming in glory, in majesty, and in power.
Ayingirawo mu bitiibwa mu bukulu ne mu buyinza.
And in today's text,
kati bw'olaba byandikibwa bya leero,
it captures the picture for us.
Bajjayo ekifaananyi ekyo.
John explains as he opens up this account.
Yokaana annyonnyola ng'atandika olugero luno.
He says, "Now I saw the heaven open."
Tinenda beggulu nga libikuddwa.
This is heaven opening to reveal the majesty and glory of its King and Redeemer.
Bakula gegulunga libi kudua okwolesa akitiibwa n'obukulu bwa Mukama waayo era omununuzi.
And then behold a white horse.
Ne bakula ge embala endogo embala asenjeru.
So the first thing that John sees is the white horse.
Ekintu yokana kyasoka okulaba y'embala asenjeru.
Why does the white horse come at this point?
Rachel and embalase njeru wejida muka seda.
Remember the last time he's seen on earth.
Jukida we assemble kulabi kwa kukuziku.
Riding an animal.
Nga atambulida kumsolo.
It was a foal, the young of a donkey.
Yali mwana gwendo goyi.
As he made his way to Jerusalem.
Nga ingira Jerusalem.
He didn't get into Jerusalem as a conquering general.
Tia ingira Jerusalem ingomu dumizi wa majava murutalo.
No. Now, John sees a white horse.
Katiyoka na bamula alave ndogo embalase njeru.
When he comes again,
ira wana akomera
wone. He will come as a conquering general.
Ayingira ngo mudumizi weje omuwanguzi.
The white horse is a symbol.
Katene embalase njeru kabonero.
Christ's triumph over the forces of wickedness.
Akobuwanguzi ba Kristo eri amanyi gonna ag'ekibi.
In the world.
Agali
so mwuzi. Having seen that triumphant picture.
Ng'omaze okulaba ekifaananyi ekyo eky'obuwanguzi.
The focus then comes to the rider.
Amaaso ne bagatunuza ku muvuzi.
And John now begins to expound to show us who the rider is.
Yokana na jayono mufuzi wembalasi.
And he says in verse 11, and he who sat on him.
Ira gamba munyirirwa 11 nti ne oyali ajituddeko.
Was called faithful and true.
Ngaitibwa mwesigwa era wa mazima.
And in righteousness.
Iranga mu butuukirivu.
He judges and makes war.
Asala emisango ate alwana.
So the rider on this white horse is defined for us.
Katona tudde ku mbalasi enjeru annyonnyolwa wano.
Using several names.
Bamuwa amannya mangi.
The first name that we see here.
Erinnya erisookerwako wano.
He is called faithful and true.
Ayitibwa wa mazima era mwesigwa.
And it is in this capacity.
Era mu kitiibwa ekyo.
Of being faithful and true.
Okubeera wa mazima ngate wa mwenkanya.
That he comes to judge and to make war.
Awo mwajiga okusala emisango n'okulwana.
But all this he does in perfect justice.
Byonna bikola mu bwenkanya obutuukiridde.
What is the implication of this?
Kati wano jjawo ki?
The implication of this is this. That what has so long been promised by scripture.
Ebyo ebyawandiikwa bizze nga bitusuubiza.
Will come to pass.
Olwo birituukirira.
All the wrongs will be made right.
Byonna ebyakyama bijja kutereera.
So all the cheating, all the scams that we are familiar with today will be exposed and corrected.
obukumpanya n'obufere bwetulaba mu biro bino olunaku bujja kutereera.
So all the crime and all the violence will be brought to an end.
Emisango n'okutulugunyizibwa bijja kukoma.
So all hatred among humans will cease.
Obukyayi mu bantu bulikoma ku kaseera ako.
Why? Because Jesus is coming.
Yesu ajja.
He comes as a judge of the earth.
Ajja ng'omulamuzi asala emisango ku nsi.
He comes to right all matters.
Ajja kutereeza ensonga zonna.
So there is nothing that will be crooked that will not be made right.
Tejja kubayo kyakyama ekitajja kutereezebwa.
There is no sin that will not be judged.
Teri kibi kyebatajja kusalira musango.
There is no incorrectness that will not be corrected.
Teri kitali kituufu kyebatajja kutereeza.
The second description we have of him.
Okunnyonnyola okuddako kwe batuwa.
The Bible says his eyes were like a flame of fire.
Bible egamba amaaso ge gali ng'omuliro ogwaka.
And on his head many crowns.
Nga ne ku mutwe kwe kuliko engule nnyingi.
He had a name written that no one knew except himself.
Nga alina erinnya eriwandiikiddwa nga teri alimanyi okuggyako ye yekka.
That is the description that we have in verse 12.
Okwo okunnyonnyola okusanga mu lunyiri lwa 12.
But let's begin with the unknown name.
Katsoke kulinye
litamanyikintwa. This unknown name, I believe, when you read the text, is linked to the description that has just been brought before us.
Likwatagana n'okunnyonnyola ke basusutuwa.
And the description involves the eyes.
Okunnyonnyola okwo kusookera kulimu n'amaaso.
It says the eyes were like a flame of fire.
Amaaso gaali nga omuliro ogwokya.
Blazing.
Ogwocha.
And the crown on his head, which it would be called, in certain versions are called diadems.
Ngengule ziri ku mutwe gwe.
So now the eyes,
amaso,
speak of the full discernment and penetrating knowledge.
Gakiikirira okutegeera okwa waggulu n'okumanya buli bintu byonna n'ebikwekeddwa.
So it speaks to wisdom beyond understanding.
Awo boogera ku kutegeera n'amagezi agasukkuluma ku kutegeera.
Now the diadems or the crowns speak of full authority.
Kati engule zikiikirira obufuzi obw'enkomeredde.
Now look at the eyes talking about wisdom and understanding and knowledge.
Kati kwata amaaso agakiikirira amagezi n'okutegeera.
In all its fullness.
Mu bujjuvu bwakyo.
And look at the crowns representing authority.
Omala otunuulira engule ezikiikirira obufuzi.
And power.
N'obuyinza.
Now, the eyes is the picture of omniscience.
Kata amaaso kye kifaananyi ky'okumanya byonna.
So it pictures him as all-knowing.
Bamulaga wano nti y'amanyi buli kimu.
This is the attribute of divine.
Kino kye kifaananyi eky'obwakatonda.
Now, the crowns picture him as omnipotent.
Kati engule zikiikirira oyo asinga obuyinza bwonna.
So now omniscience and omnipotent.
Kati amanyi byonna n'owobuyinza bwonna.
Now come together in this picture of a man.
Kati bigattibwamu mu kifaananyi ky'omuntu.
Now look at the picture that we are trying to talk about.
Wetegereze ekifaananyi kye tujjayo wano.
In Jesus Christ.
Kati mu Yesu
Kristo. Omniscience.
Okumanya kwonna.
And omnipotence.
Na buli bumaanyi na buyinza bwonna.
Are vested in this man.
Byonna biri mu muntu omu.
Jesus Christ.
Ye Yesu Kristo.
All knowledge.
Okumanya kwonna.
And all power.
N'obuyinza bwonna.
And this is the point of the text.
Kati ye omuntu omukulu mu byawandiikibwa.
You see, the wonder of Jesus.
Kati ebyewuunyisa ku Yesu.
Is that as a man.
Ye nga mu buntu.
He manifests the fullness of godliness.
Ayolesa obwakatonda obujjudde.
He is both man.
Ng'ate muntu.
And 100% God.
Ng'ate mu kiseera kye kimu Katonda mu bujjuvu.
And that is what points to his name.
Ekyo kyekyogera ku linnya liri.
The name that is unknown but is revealed.
Erinnya terimanyikiddwa naye baleese okubikkulibwa kwalyo.
What does this suggest? This suggests that no one knows the full extent of the mystery of the union of God and man.
kitegeza antiteria amanyo kubikobo kutegiru kwecha mechi echa katona nga yegase wa muno muno.
So that mystery is known only to him.
Echa mechi yeye kaya achimanyo.
It is only him who understands how he can be 100% man.
Yeye kaya amanyo kitegezo kubango olimuntu.
And possess all the omniscience and omnipotence of God.
Ate no sigalango sigazo bwa Katonda bonobo kumanya n'obuyinza wamu.
In a human body.
Ngabwonna buli muntu omuntu omubiri.
I know several commentators have tried to describe this.
Banja abatafuta Bible bagezezaako okunnyonnyola wano.
But when you listen to what they are trying to describe,
ne wowuliriza bagezaako okunnyonnyola,
it borders on heresy. It does not make sense. And the fact is this, what the Bible describes, that this is the name that is not known to anyone. Because a name describes. So this description is known only to him. Our finite minds cannot comprehend it. Paul talks about it as the mystery of godliness. How God became man and still retained the godliness on him. And manifested the weakness of man. Yet was completely God. And completely man. It's a mystery that is a wonderful revelation. That in Christ Jesus is vested the full authority. Power.
N'obuyinza,
omniscience,
n'okumanya kwonna,
and omnipotence of God.
N'obuyinza bwonna obw'obwa Katonda.
He's not any less on any account.
Taina wakendeddeko.
It is something that no one fully knows.
Ekyo teri muntu amanyi okutegeera kwakyo mu bujjuvu.
And in our journey, we shall be discovering new aspects of this throughout all eternity. That is why I believe heaven is constantly breaking out in praise and worship at the new wonders of what our Lord and God looks like. Why? Because God's revelation of himself in Jesus will not be completely seen until when we see him face to face. That's what Paul describes to us in 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 12. When he says we see in part, we know in part, but when we see him, then we shall see him in all his fullness and glory. Now, can we go to the third name? The third name is the Word of God. And this Word of God that we see in verse 12, verse 13, that Word of God is associated with the robe that is dipped in blood, with the armies of heaven following him.
Ekigambo kya Katonda ekyo kitambulira wamu n'ekyambalo ekyannyikibwa mu musaayi n'amagye agajja nga gamugoberera.
As well as the sword that comes out of his mouth.
Wamu n'ekitala ekiva mu kamwa ke.
And I know some commentators have looked at the robe dipped in blood and say this describes what Isaiah 63 from verse 1 to 4 talks about.
Abamu abatafuta Bible bagamba nti ekyambalo ekyannyikibwa mu musaayi kitambulira wamu n'ekyo kye boogerako Isaaya esura ya 63.
But Whereas that gives him the picture of an all-conquering Messiah.
Wadenga chimuje mchifana nyecho mununuzi omuanguzi wabyo na.
I believe this further points to Calvary.
Zikiriza wano fechitu tunuza ku Calvary.
And the descriptive of the sacrifice that was paid.
No kutulago kutunyonyola sadake ya webwayo.
You see, there is what was visible to the eye.
Kati waliwo fechola ba maso gafe.
At Calvary.
We are at Calvary.
And there is what was not visible to the human eye.
Kati waliwo echo chitutalaba na maso gafe.
So to us who were seeing a suffering servant.
Kati fabala bomuddu abona abona.
Crowned with blood all over his face.
Ngaliko nengule yono musaye gubiso echenyiche.
His body beaten.
Omubiri gukubiddwa.
Bleeding, dying.
Guvamo musaye ngali mukufa.
On the other side, what we cannot see.
Na yeri gwecho talaba.
Is what Paul reveals to us.
Echo Paulo kubikulibwa yaku akuwa.
That this looked like a defeat.
Ti wanugwe walabango muntu amegedwa.
On the other side, it was the conquest.
Ngate kului luri atelwe bwali obuwanguzi.
Him triumphing over sin.
Yenga wangule chibi.
Him triumphing over disease.
Nga wangule mduwadi.
Him triumphing over sickness.
Nga wangule bulichirwadi.
Him pouring out his blood.
Okuyiwa musaibwe.
To the covering of many sins.
Okubike bibyo nevinji.
From the foundations of the world.
Okutandika kumusinji gwensi.
To the very end.
Paka kukumerero yensi.
What a mighty picture that we could not see.
Eche chifana ncha amanyi tuwale mokuchiraba.
And until the veil was torn.
Paka ejijiwe liya yuzibuamu.
And the way was made.
Ekubo neditu teke wawo.
That all would now approach the throne of grace.
Ngabuliyoma asobolo genda kunamulonde yechisa.
With boldness.
Mubuvumu.
And obtain mercy and grace.
Awewe chisa doku sasirwa.
To help us in our time of need.
Okuyambi wa mukasira kubweta.
That was not sin.
Echo tetuachi zaba.
That was what was happening behind the scene.
Kate chuchichari elife chetutalaba.
You see, when we see the movies today.
Filmu zetulaba.
Or we see the plays.
Name is Zanyo.
What we see is what they want you to see. But there is preparation going on behind the scene. There is something actually happening behind the scenes, and you need to go behind the scenes to actually see what is happening. Otherwise, you only end up seeing what they want you to see. But let's get back here. Why the word of God? You see, the word of God indicates his communicable Godhead. So which is joined to manhood. Which he shall manifest in glory. You see, just as our minds and hearts are revealed to others by our words. So when we speak, people understand our hearts. When we speak, we allow people to see our minds. Even so, the Father reveals himself to
us
through his Son, who is the incarnate word. So it is Christ or Jesus Christ who reveals to us the heart and the mind of the Father. Why? Because he is the word incarnate. He is the word that has been made flesh. Let's go deeper on this because it gets interesting. Because every word comes from an alphabet. And so words are made up of letters. So when we get the letters and add them together, we form words and then form sentences. So it comes back to the letters.
And in
every letters or every word does come from an alphabet.
So
you have an alphabet in the English book from A to Z.
And
now this gets interesting. Because like you have an English alphabet,
there
is also a spiritual alphabet.
What?
Now, in the Greek, they call the first letter is the Alpha. And the last letter is
Omega.
So when Christ is described,
he's
described as the Alpha and the Omega.
Now
this is very interesting.
Because
then what that means, every word of God
is a
revelation of
Christ
in his human
form. The
word made incarnate.
So
he is the divine alphabet of God's revelation.
To us. And
you see, as the word of God was the agent of creation. John tells us in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. All things were made through Him. Without Him, there was nothing made that was made. In Him was life. And the life was the light of
men.
Watch this. The Word
Chigambo
was the agent of God's creation.
Katonda mweyayitira okutonda.
That is the beginning.
Yenkomerero.
That is the Alpha.
Oyo ye Alpha.
The Word also
ate chigambo chechimu
is the agent of God's judgment.
Katonda mweyayitira okusala emisango
and consummation.
No,
that is why he is called the Omega.
Yensonga racha ataitibwa Omega.
So he was the agent of creation.
Kati okutondebwa konna kwaitira mu ye.
He is also the agent of consummation.
Ate ebyonna biwumbibwa wamu okuyitira mu ye.
So when you refer to Jesus as the Alpha and the Omega,
woyita wobo Yesu wobogerako nti Alpha ate Omega.
The implication of this, that like he was the agent in bringing everything to pass, he's also the agent to bring everything to judgment and conclusion. That is why we call him the spiritual alphabet of God's revelation to man. Hallelujah to Jesus. Now accompanying him, the Bible says, are angels. It is an army of saints. Jude quotes Enoch,
Yuda ayogerako Enoka,
the prophet.
Nabi.
And in verse 14 he says, I saw the Lord coming with tens of thousands of saints. We have already encountered him coming when John gave us a peek in Revelation chapter 17 and verse
14.
When he comes with his chosen one, those that he has called, chosen, and the faithful followers of his. The Bible tells us they will accompany him when he comes. This describes Jesus returning.
awo batulaga Yesu ngadda
accompanied by the heavenly host
ngawerekedwa ejeri omuguru
then shall appear with him in glory
bajja kulabika wamu naye nga bali mu kitiibwa
not only the saints but armies of the angels as well
siba tukuvuboka ninga bagatiddwako n'amajega abamalayika
this shall be millions and millions of saints
nga abatukuvu bali mu bukadde n'obukadde
and they too will use the sword of the spirit
nabo bajja kukozesa ekitala ky'omwoyo
which is the word of God
nga kyekigambo kya Katonda
now when he comes
era bw'alirabika
he comes as a conqueror
ayingirawo ng'omuwanguzi
he comes as a mighty army
ayingirawo ng'eggye eddene
he comes as the Lord of hosts
alabika nga mukama we omutumizi we
which brings us to the fourth name The Bible tells us in verse 16 that the rider's fourth name is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. So this is linked to him ruling with an iron scepter. This places him above all principalities and powers. Now, it is not that he is not King of Kings and Lord of Lords now. As we speak, he's King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And the scriptures tell us he is seated at the right hand of the Father. In the fullness of time, John then writes, it shall be revealed to us. Then his name as King of Kings and Lord of Lords will be made manifest to all creation. There will not be any doubt that there is no name in heaven on earth under the earth, under the sea, that will not bow at the name Jesus. Here is what is fulfilled that was spoken in the book of Philippians, where Paul writes and says, every knee shall bow, and every tongue will confess that he is Lord, the glory of God the Father. So it may not be apparent now, but the fact is, he is Lord. But it will be made visible to every creation that Jesus Christ is the King of Kings. So it doesn't matter which king is there, it doesn't matter which lord is there, he is the King of Kings. But I just take you a step back. You see, those that believe in the Lord Jesus, the scriptures tell us that he has made them kings and priests unto God. So we that believe on his name, he places us into a place of loyalty. That's why Peter calls us royal priesthood. So it is a place where we are kings. So he is the King of Kings. And he is the Lord of Lords. So everything comes to his obedience. And the scripture tells us he will rule with an iron scepter. You see, when the Lord comes, he will rule over nations. First of all, he will destroy the evil ones. And then he will rule over the rest. And when you see this through the lens of the second Psalm, The rod of iron is a symbol of tough justice. You say iron does not bend easily. This speaks of unwavering righteousness. It talks about a standard of God's morality, which he cannot bend, which he cannot diminish, which he cannot lessen. It is that, and it is that. That is his rod. That is his standard. And this is descriptive of the millennial reign. When the righteousness shall reign with Jesus on this earth for 1,000 years. Why have we said all this? Why the four names? I don't want you to miss the point. The point is this: Jesus Christ is coming again. His first coming was characterized by meekness and humility. He willingly laid his life for the sins of this world. We shall never see him again like that. When he comes again, he will come as a mighty conqueror. He will come, number two, as a judge. He will come, number three, as a king. He will come, number four, as the Lord. The question I ask, are you ready for his coming? If you are not ready, I have good news for you. You can be ready. The journey begins now. By you surrendering to the Lordship of Jesus Christ, allow His Spirit to fill you, to guide you, to lead you. As many as are led by the Spirit of God, the Bible says those are the children of God. So if you are not led by the Spirit of God, then you are none of His. That is the significant feature or characteristic of the children of God. Why? Because when we believe in Jesus Christ, He fills us with His Spirit. And His Spirit leads us. His Spirit guides us. His Spirit anchors us in the truth. His Spirit sanctifies us. Thank you, Holy Spirit. His Spirit is here to empower us to live for Him. His Spirit graces us to overcome sin. His Spirit is here to cleanse us, that at His appearing, together corporately, we shall be a church without spot or wrinkle. For when He shall appear, the Bible says, we shall be like Him. It begins now by you accepting Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. The Bible says we believe with our hearts and are justified. We confess with our mouth and are saved. It is as simple as that. Believing that Jesus came
kiriza nti Yesu yajja
to die for a sinner like you.
Okufirira ababi nga gwe.
And he shed his blood for you and I.
Naiwe omusayi gwe kululwa n'olwange.
Believe the sacrifice that he paid.
Kiriza sadaka gye yasasula.
That it alone.
Eyo yokka.
Without anything added to it.
Nga toyongeddeko birala byonna.
Is necessary for you to be saved. Allow him to come in your life. He says, behold, I stand at the door. Knocking. Will you allow him to come in and dine with you? And you dine with him. That is the wonderful invitation. Right now. He's knocking at the door of your heart. This applies to everyone. It applies for the sinner. It applies for the saint. Remember when he's writing this, John is writing to the church. But let's first address the sinner. You who needs to be saved. Why don't you say this prayer from the bottom of your heart? Ask the Lord to forgive you, to wash you, to cleanse you, to fill you with His Holy Spirit. Say, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you for your love and for your mercy, for your grace and your compassion for us. I acknowledge that I am a sinner and I need a Savior. And no other Savior but Jesus alone. Therefore, Lord Jesus, I ask that you be the Lord and the Savior of my life. From this day forward, fill me with your Holy Spirit. Lead me from this day forward until I see your beautiful face. Lord of glory, I thank you. And I believe that you died for sinners. Rose and are seated at the right hand of the Father. I know that you are coming again. And whether I'm on this side of eternity or on the other side, on this side I believe you will come for me. Then I believe I shall be with you forever. Thank you for saving. Thank you for filling me with your Holy Spirit. Thank you for writing my name in the Lamb's book. Thank you for empowering me to live for you. In your mighty name I pray, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you have made that prayer, you have been wonderfully saved. The reason number on your screen, please call it. Someone will receive
it,
provide you the basic instruction on this wonderful journey of faith, where the grace of God infuses your life, empowers your life, and enables you to live victoriously for Jesus. Now, for you who is born again, the scriptures tell us, Jesus says in the book of Revelation, behold, I stand at the door. Why is he making that comment to the church? Because many of us have come to a point where, like the season of Christmas is, the flurry of activities has crowded out the Messiah. The Christ no longer the focus, is no longer the apex, is no longer the heartbeat of your life. Everything else is and not Christ. Today, invite him in. He promises to come in only if you invite him. And he will dine with you.
erajja kutula wamu nawe.
And you with him.
Nawe wamu naye.
So why don't you pray this prayer?
Sabe sale.
Say, dear Lord Jesus.
Ai mukama Yesu.
The activities of this world.
Ebintu byonna eby'okunsi.
The desires of this world.
Okuyaayaana okuli mu nsi.
The passions around me.
N'ebintu byenjagala nnyo ebineetoolodde.
Has caused me to sway.
Bindeetedde okuva ku mulamwa.
And focus on so many things other than you.
Essira n'eriteeka ku birala okujjako ggwe.
I come to you once more, my Lord.
Zizze mu maaso g'omukama wange.
I invite you in my life.
Nkwanirizo gye mu bulamu bwange.
That together we may have this moment of fellowship.
Wamu tubere n'akaseera ak'okussa ekimu.
That lasts for entire lifetime.
Akabeerera emirembe gyonna.
Through all eternity.
Okuyita mu mirembe gyonna.
Lord,
mukama wange,
fill me again with your spirit.
Zijuza nate n'omwoyo mutukuvu.
Lord,
mukama,
I yield to your spirit.
Newaayo eri omwoyo.
Holy Spirit, I yield to your leading.
Mwoyo mutukuvu newaddeyo eri obukulembeze bwo.
My thoughts,
mubirowoozo,
my heart,
mitima,
my soul and my mind.
Ememe yange n'ebirowoozo byange.
Take it and use it.
Bitwale obikozese.
To the glory.
Eri ekitiibwa.
The honor.
Netendo.
And the praise.
N'okuwoyo okusinza.
My Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Okwa mukama wange omulokozi Yesu Kristo.
Thank you, Lord.
Webale mukama.
Amen.
Amen.
Now if you have made this prayer.
Osabye sale.
This is the beginning of wonderful things.
Otandise olugendo lw'ebintu ebyewuunyisa.
The Spirit of the Lord.
Omwoyo wa mukama.
Will flood your heart.
Ajja kujjuza omutima.
I pray the Spirit of the Lord.
Saba omwoyo wa mukama.
Will be so real to you. That still small voice will be so evident. That today may mark the beginning of great things in your life. Great things that happen when we yield our will to the will of the Spirit.
Tusoka kuwaayo okwagala kwaffe eri okwagala kw'omwoyo.
Great things that happen.
Ebintu bibaawo ebinene.
When we yield our right to be.
We tuwaayo eddembe lyaffe okubeerawo.
Allow him.
Ne tumukkiriza.
Who created us.
Oyo omutonzi waffe.
Who knows us.
Nga yatumanyi.
To lead and guide all the way.
Atukulembera atukulungamye mu lugendo lwonna.
So as we embark on this journey.
Era tuyingira mu lugendo luno.
We hope to hear wonderful testimonies.
Tusuubira okufuna obujulizi obulungi.
Please share with us what God is doing.
Mugabanire wamu ebyo Katonda byakola.
Let's celebrate the goodness of God.
Tusanyukire wamu eri obulungi bwa Mukama.
Therefore, from Dominion Church.
Era okuva mu kanisa ya Dominion.
We say shalom.
Tugamba mirembe.
God richly bless you.
Mukama abawe omukisa.
Till we meet again.
Okay, tuddamu okusisinkana.
Amen.
Amina.